Hi, I'm Leslie McVeigh. Welcome to CTN Member Highlight. Today, my special guest is Tom Hendel, the Executive Director of CTN. Hi, Tom.
Hi, yeah, here I am in the hot seat.
Yeah, isn't this funny? Now, why are you here?
Because we have something big coming up that we need to talk about. Our telethon, our first annual 25-hour telethon in September. It's going to be September 22nd, Friday night at 9 p.m. to 10 p.m. on Saturday night, September 23rd.
And it's going to be full of all kinds of surprises and musicians. And tell us a little bit about who's going to be on the show.
Well, we have the mayor of Portland, Ethan Strimling, kicking it off. And then we have a whole string of different local musicians. We have Michael Heath. We have David Bullard, Lacuna, KG Freeze, Excuse Me. We have a number of bands right up to 3 o'clock in the morning.
And Heath McVeigh.
Heath McVeigh.
Just a shout out to a relative, and he's going to be on.
Yes, he is. He is. And then we have at 3 o'clock Social Bridge Dance Party, which is a reggae dance party with a DJ, right through to 6 o'clock in the morning. So that if you're ready to party all through the night, this is the place to come or tune into on your TV set. And then at 6 o'clock in the morning, we cool down a little bit with a yoga class. And then at 7 o'clock, we have USM videos with one of our board members, a professor at the Media Studies Department at USM, showing different videos, short videos from USM. At 8 o'clock, we have our own president of the board, Abby McGilvery, and she does our interview show, Being Brave, but this time she's interviewing her son and his friends. So that's, kids can tune in and find out what it's like
to be a kid.
To be a kid, yeah. Or to be brave as a kid. And then at 9 o'clock, we're going to have a musician, Alex Armstrong. And he's just a recent volunteer here also at CTN. The morning and the afternoon are filled with a whole bunch of different things. We have sound journeys. Ben Carroll plays these glass crystals and sings in tune with them. We have the city council debate happening later in the afternoon. We have Young Talents of Maine, which is a series of different talented people. We have a playback theater. Meg Christie from Playback Theater is going to do an improv class. We have a Tai Chi class. We have a golf talk. We have people talking about golf, people talking about softball. We have Lighthouse Jubilees. And in the evening, we are going to have the Circus Maine here, Portland Ballet, Viva Singing, and Primo Cubano. So it's
Leslie
Murray in a flute, yes.
Direct from Shanghai.
Right, yeah. And so we have we have an artist paint-off happening, actually.
Oh, that's going to be fun.
Yeah, where four artists are going to be painting to music, and while they're painting, people can call in and place bids on the paintings.
And, you know, that is so much fun to watch. We just saw that in Spain.
Oh, really?
At a jazz festival, and it was like, oh, my gosh, you couldn't take your eyes off the
artists. We had a show like this a few months ago, and it was really interesting.
Well, I mean, this is fabulous. People can come down here to 516 Congress Street anytime during that 25 hours.
Right.
They can pay a small fee, and they get some kind of stamp or something
so they can keep coming back.
If they come Friday night, they can come again Saturday.
For yoga class in the morning, and then come back in the evening.
Yeah, after breakfast or whatever.
Whatever, yeah.
And children under 12 will be free, which is nice for families who want to.
And the purpose of this is to showcase all the local talent that can be on community television, as well as to raise money for the station. We're going to be asking them. We're hoping this is going to be one of our big annual fundraisers every year. And so for $20, people can become a member. That means they get to vote at the annual meeting. They get our newsletter. So there's a lot of benefits. And there might be some prizes along the way. I just mentioned some of the people who are painting will give their classes. The Friends of Fort Gorgeous just donated 2 free tickets in 2018 for a tour. So we might put that up for available to the highest bidder for an hour and prizes like that. Yeah. So
and what a treat that would be to be able to go see what they're doing at the fort. A lot of people can't get out there.
Right.
That sounds fantastic.
Yeah, yeah. It's going to be a fun 25 hours. There's a few of us staying up for all 25 hours.
I think I might be one of those few.
And we'll hold each other up, but it'll be a spectacle no matter what, and a really good reason to call in and donate. Yeah. It'll be online to streaming. So if you don't, right. if you can't come down, or you want
to watch it, just turn your computer right. on, and anywhere in the world,
right.
people can be
anywhere
watching
anywhere in the world. You can
and
watch it live.
And they can donate from anywhere in the world.
And donate. You can donate online
right.
or call in and donate.
We prefer U.S. dollars, but we'll take anything.
Yes, we will. We will.
Thank you, Tom. I'm looking forward to it.
Oh, I'm looking forward to it too.